I'm making this video just to talk about how I feel about the passing of Whitney Houston. Okay, y'all might think I'm like kind of crazy, but although I didn't know her personally, it's crazy how it's really possible for a musician's music to affect the listener. So, you know, there are moments in our life where we go through things, and to get through whatever it is that we're going through, you sometimes turn to music, whether it be gospel music, R&B, hip-hop. For my culture, most of the time it's gospel music. God helps you get through that troubling time. If it's someone with love, you might turn to an R&B song. But a lot of Whitney Houston songs kind of describe my life, especially Exhale. The line, life never tells us the winds are wide.
Life never tells us the winds are wise.
And, you know, you always want to know what's coming at you, but God didn't make things that way. You take things as it comes. But I really love Whitney Houston. Loved her music, the person she was, even in her downtime. I was like, don't be talking about Whitney like that. My first talent show song was The Greatest Love of All. So I feel like I have this special connection to Whitney. Themselves. She was a very special woman. Awesome voice, awesome music, awesome actress. She was just very special, and the world lost an angel at the age of 48. And I just wanted to make this video to express how I was feeling about the whole situation. I've been just crying, watched the funeral yesterday. BB Ryan's part made me cry, like the tears just start flowing. And when they lifted that casket up and started playing And I Will Always Love You, try not to cry now, because I just watched the BT Remembers Whitney thing, and Kim Burrell told her story about nobody wanted to rub Whitney's foot, and she rubbed it. And Whitney said, that showed me that you really love me.
Getting her hair and makeup done, let me try to say this without getting upset. She needed her feet rubbed because she just kind of wanted to relax. And so there were some people there to do that for her, but they didn't feel like it. So I said, give me the lotion. Do my sister like that.
That's right.
And so I grabbed her feet, and I started massaging her feet, and her head was back, her eyes were closed because they were doing her hair and makeup, and then tears started coming down her face. And I said, why are you crying? She said, because you love me.
You okay?
Yeah.
I guess you all know who this is, huh?
Bobby, 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 my baby, my little girl, oh, she inspires me, and she gives me joy, 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 joy. And mommy loves you, girl. You don't have to worry about a thing, because I'm standing right by your side. Don't worry,
can you shoot? Can you shoot? Not gonna shoot. So I come up here and show you pretty dress.
Dad did it. Dad did it. Dad made you come up here and do this.
She's an amazing person. Love her music. I just wanted to make this video to talk about my feelings on her as an artist, as a musician, as someone whose voice has really impacted the world. And I really think her mother made an awesome decision on having her funeral in the place where her voice developed and thrived, and she showed the world what it looked like to have a funeral in a black family. She took them, the world knows how we do things. It was an awesome ceremony, but just wanted to make this video to talk about how I feel, and kind of sad right now, but we have her music and her movies, and you know, God does everything for a reason, and that's how I feel. We love you, Whitney.
I got the stuff that you want.